This episode of DNews is brought to you by Canon PIXMA Pro professional inkjet printers, exactly as you envisioned. There is way too much UV light in the universe. So stock up on some SPF 50 and we're good, right? Well, not if you're an astronomer. Hey there, fellow enlightenment sources. Julian here for DNews. Right now in the world of astronomy, there's something of a sticky wicket. Astronomers have observed 5 times more ultraviolet light than they can account for. That's not a minor miscalculation. That means something is really wrong with our model of the universe. UV light is detected because it strips hydrogen atoms of their electrons, ionizing them. By taking the amount of ionized gas we can find, we can get a pretty good idea of how much UV light is whipping around through space. So far, so good. But obviously that UV light has to come from somewhere. And obviously stars like our sun give off UV light as part of the electromagnetic spectrum they emit. Quasars are the super bright regions surrounding supermassive black holes at the center of galaxies, and they're getting compressed and heated so much that they're an enormous source of UV light. But when astronomers tally the numbers from the stars and quasars and compare it to the amount of ionized gas they've observed, they come up short. Unacceptably short. It's like when your mom asks for change from that 5 she gave you for candy and you act like, you have no idea where it went. So, where could all this extra light be coming from? One suggestion is dark matter. Aha, I hear you say, because you're a critical thinker and I love that about you. Dark matter, which is still an unproven hypothesis, you continue, should not absorb or emit electromagnetic radiation. That's why it's called dark matter. Man, you're smart and handsome. And you're right. So blaming the discrepancy on dark matter looks a lot like grasping at straws. But there's a chance it is the culprit. The best hypothesis to explain dark matter is weakly interacting massive particles, or WIMPs. That's what passes as a joke in the science world. Some proposed variations of WIMPs could decay and release ultraviolet photons. And since dark matter accounts for over 80% of the mass in the universe, that could be enough to make up the difference. And if that's really what's happening, then this accounting error could lead to direct proof of dark matter and exactly what it is. Of course, if that's not what's happening, we're going to have to rethink our model of the universe a bit. The UV light conundrum is a great example of science in action. To quote Isaac Asimov, the most exciting phrase to hear in science, the one that heralds new discoveries, is not "Eureka," but that's funny. Obviously, you can't just take a picture of dark matter, but for everything you can see, you can capture it with a Canon. And when you want to print your glorious proof of that moment in time, Canon's got you there too, with Canon PIXMA Pro professional inkjet printers. You can expect a level of quality and accuracy that keeps each print true to your unique vision, all backed up by Canon's commitment to provide professionals with fast, high-quality service you can depend on. For more info on dark matter and what it means for sci-fi, Anthony, in his rare beardless form, has a video for you on that right over here. Can you think of other times mistakes led to scientific revolutions? Let us know in the comments, be sure to subscribe, and keep tuning in to DNews for more addictive knowledge. This episode of DNews is brought to you by Canon PIXMA Pro professional inkjet printers, exactly as you envisioned.